you're going to agape this morning's Carolina people. Find out what it's all about coming up next. Good morning. Welcome to Carolina People. This morning we're at Myrtle Beach Lighting, the lighting store of the year at 4897 Highway 17 Bypass South in Myrtle Beach. We're focused on Agape Senior, and we're visiting with its Chief Executive Officer, Scott Middleton. Good morning, Scott.
Good morning.
And a happy Friday the 13th. We wouldn't normally say that, but since you are a minister, we can say that you're protecting us.
That's
this
right.
Morning.
I'm not superstitious.
You can make sure and lift it up. That's right.
Exactly. Yeah.
A great day and a great week. A lot going on this week. Myrtle Beach Lighting was kind enough to let us in early. Actually, they're not quite yet open, but letting us in early. Have you been in the store before?
No, this is the first time I've been down here, but gosh, they've got a lot of stuff.
It is tremendous, light after light. I don't know how they keep it cool in this place.
Yeah, they must have some good air conditioning systems in here.
A great AC system, absolutely. Scott, are you originally from the area?
No, actually, I grew up upstate in Lawrence is where I was born, but I've been vacationing down at Garden City all my life. And in fact, my wife was her grandfather built the third house at Garden City. Owned tons of lots up on Front Beach and thought people were absolutely crazy to build any kind of house on the sand up there because he knew a hurricane would blow it away.
Right.
And in fact, the last house that they owned got blown away during Hurricane Hugo. And so we've been vacationing down here all of our lives, and this is kind of a second home for us.
Is your wife also from Lawrence?
No, she grew up in North Carolina.
Okay,
The western part of it. Her dad's a Methodist preacher, and so was she.
Yes.
And so she traveled around about every 3 or 4 years. They moved on from one church to the next.
And that is, for viewers who aren't in the Methodist denomination or aren't familiar with it, the Methodist ministers always travel around?
Exactly, they do. And they are reappointed by the pastor. In fact, next Wednesday will be moving day. And so there will probably be about 150 Methodist preachers in South Carolina who will all be moving on that day. And so they literally pack up their house and they'll be moving into a house that somebody just unpacked up and left and be moving into it.
Wow, Scott. Now, I think I saw you're also, am I correct, a Methodist minister as well?
Yes, I'm an ordained Methodist minister. Right. I preached in South Carolina all over the state for about 10 years and then left out about 15 years ago and went back to school and got a master's in healthcare administration.
Great.
And went to work in taking care of senior adults in South Carolina.
That's tremendous. What a great commitment.
Yeah, it's been, it's a very rewarding experience. I worked with a lot of seniors in my churches. I found some very deplorable conditions in nursing homes across the state. I knew that something needed to be done differently, and so that was my vow to set up an opportunity to really be able to take care of seniors in a faith-based environment and also in a safe and secure environment.
Faith-based is a very important part of it.
It certainly is, and that's kind of the foundation of Agape Senior. We are a faith-based organization, not that we discriminate against anybody. We have people of lots of different faiths who work with us and live with us. We are mainly Christian-based.
Right.
Our logo, as you could probably see on a lot of our material, and actually
can't
the star
really
here.
See it too well here, but if they visit agapesenior.com, it's very prominent. And I was going to ask you about that in a little bit, but go ahead.
Well, the logo is a nine-pointed star, and the 9 points represent the fruits of the Spirit from Galatians 5, and you can go look up Galatians 5 and read those.
Yeah.
And those are the basic principles of how we operate our business and taking care of our residents through basically faith and love. And so we expect all the folks who are employed with Agape to exhibit those fruits of the Spirit as they take care of the residents.
And not
on
to
a
put you
basis.
On the spot, could you recite them? Are there nine fruits or nine?
There are nine fruits, and I knew you would ask me to do that. And
that's
why I brought them.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. No, that's I'm kidding. Yeah, it is Friday the 13th, so.
And it's awful early in the morning.
It is.
On the back of our name tags, we also list all of those fruits of the Spirit to remind people of that. Because sure enough, I'll leave one out.
Oh, I know. That's right. We'd be counting down. It'll be a long shot. No, I'm kidding. It's just a great opportunity, of course, to get you in. As you travel, I think you highlighted that you all are literally half the state. I mean, Rock Hill, the Midlands, the Strand, the PD. I mean, you've got a tremendous presence throughout the state.
Yeah, one of the things that we discovered that we needed to do differently with healthcare is we really feel like that healthcare for seniors is a very regional based, and everywhere you go, whether it's in the PD area or the Upstate or the Piedmont area or the Midlands, the healthcare is focused a little bit differently. You have different hospital systems, different doctors groups and things.
Right.
And so what we felt like, instead of a lot of nursing home chains might have 10 or 15 different nursing homes spread out, and one would be in each little nook and cranny across the state.
Right.
What we wanted to do was concentrate our efforts in one area so that we could provide the continuum of care in a particular area. So when we decided that we wanted to come down here to the Grand Strand area,
right,
we knew that this would have to be a hub for us. So we started out with an assisted living facility that we bought over in Garden City.
Right.
We've since added on to it, and it's a 100-bed assisted living facility.
Is that right? That large?
Right here in Garden City. Beautiful one-bedroom apartments. They're about 650 square feet, full kitchen, separate bedroom, three walk-in closets, you know, these apartments. It is assisted living, and we do provide care for the residents who are there, medication administration, bathing, dressing. But we also provide a more enhanced care level for those folks who need a lot of care and need daily, hourly assistance in that building as well. But we also knew that if we were going to have assisted living, we also had to have the other component, which is the skilled nursing and rehab center.
Right.
And so we're real excited because we bought a facility up in Conway, and we're in the process of conversion of that building now. And in about 60 days, we will be licensed as a skilled nursing facility, do extensive short-term rehab,
right,
and we will also offer Horry County the first hospice house on that site.
I just met with somebody last week who was talking about a hospice house down in Merle's Inlet. Very interesting as you think about a hospice house, but this will be the first in Horry County.
Yeah, the closest hospice house that you can find right now is, I think, down in Georgetown, and there's also one in Florence, but
right,
there's not one in Horry County.
That's
so it'll be
tremendous.
Centrally located for the entire Grand Strand area right there in Conway,
right,
and it'll be a great place for folks to spend their last days in a comfortable setting receiving high quality of
share
care.
Share with viewers exactly what a hospice house is, since there is not one here in our area. You said there is one in Florence.
There is one in Florence,
okay,
that's right.
Good, yes.
Just to give folks a little bit better understanding, a lot of times people think hospice, we call in hospice when somebody is going to die in the next day or two. Hospice is actually a program that's designed for people who have a terminal illness,
right,
and have decided not to pursue aggressive treatment. They want the disease process to follow with them, and they just want to go ahead and live their life and,
right,
and die.
Right.
We have hospice patients. Generally, you have a diagnosis that says you'll live 6 months or less.
Right.
But we have had people that have been on hospice for well over a year, and hospice is a Medicare paid program. It's completely paid for by Medicare, 100%, no co-pays or deductibles or anything. We provide care to people in their home or home setting. Their home setting might be a skilled nursing facility.
Right.
It might be an assisted living facility, or maybe in their own home, where we provide nurses, nursing assistants, chaplains, social workers, activities people, just to come in and talk and play with the patients as well in that setting, and help them to have a higher quality of life. Hospice house is designed for those times when a person just can't be cared for at home any longer.
Right.
And it may be short term. It may be that they've had an episode of the flu, and while that's unrelated to what's causing them to die, they may need some more intense care. And so we can bring them in that hospice house for anywhere between 5 and 14 days,
mm-hmm,
and do short-term care. It keeps them having to go from the to a hospital.
Right.
So it's much more of a home-like setting in that hospice house than it would be just sending somebody to a hospital.
And 100% paid for by Medicare.
100% paid for by Medicare.
Wow.
Exactly.
Well, why wouldn't everyone take advantage of hospice?
You know, it that's one of the things. We actually met with the state director for hospice care yesterday, met with our corporation, and she was telling us that less than 40% of the people who qualify for hospice services actually receive them in South Carolina.
Because they A, don't know about it, or B, it's kind of like the lottery for technical education. I mean, you know, for education.
They just don't know about it. They're
right,
not aware of it. They don't know what kind of services. And also, I think that The decision has to be made to stop the aggressive treatment.
Right.
They need to understand at that point that if it's cancer, there's no more chemotherapy, no more radiation. A lot of folks aren't just ready, willing to give up that quick.
Yeah.
But we're all about helping people with quality of life, not quantity. You know, maybe we don't extend your days, but we sure hope to make those days better for you. We've just had some wonderful opportunities for hospice to do things that nobody else could do. If I could give you a story, and
Happy's
all
please,
about stories.
Scott, absolutely.
We had a couple up in the PD area, in fact, that both the husband and, or both the man and the woman were on hospice services. They both had terminal illnesses and dying. The woman has actually been in pretty bad shape and was very close to death. They lived together for about 15 years and never married.
Mm-hmm.
The wife came to us and she says, Scott, she actually told John, the guy who works for us, John, I'd like to get married before I die. Mm-hmm. Problem is, in South Carolina, both the man and the woman have to go down to the courthouse to apply for marriage license.
You know, is that right?
She's bedbound. Yeah, she's bedbound. She can't get out of the bed. And so John, through a team of our ambulance transportation people, through coordinating the transportation with our nurses, our nursing assistants, social workers, we were able to get both of them down to the courthouse. They applied for their marriage license and brought them back home. And our chaplain for Agape came in and actually performed the marriage ceremony there in their house. She was laying in her hospital bed, and the nurses had arranged a bouquet of flowers that as a veil around her head.
Oh boy!
And she was able to get married before she passed away. So, you know, what hospice is concentrating on is quality of life,
right,
doing great things for people, right, things that that they may not have gotten if we hadn't have been there.
And that's a great, whether it's Agape Senior or it's other hospice locations around the state, whether it's, not that y'all are competing, because all of y'all have that same goal of quality rather than quantity. We know it's within 6 months. You know it's Medicare supported. So there's some other great hospices all over.
Oh, yeah. There's probably 16 different hospice groups that practice out of the Grand Strand area. Folks do need to understand that they are different organizations, different companies. We are no way associated with each other. Sometimes people think, oh, it's hospice and we're all connected.
Right, all the same.
But we're not. And so some of the companies are here based out of South Carolina. We have some are for-profit, some are not-for-profit, but really their goal is all about taking care of those residents and patients. One of the things that we are offering in our hospice house is that is a little bit different than the other hospice houses that have been opened up in South Carolina is that we'll take patients from any hospice. So that if you're in one of the other hospice programs and you need to have our hospice house, then you can come in and that other hospice can still follow you, so you can have some of the same caregivers and nurses and chaplains that come in. What we found is that a lot of our other competition that have opened up hospice houses across the state have said the only way you can come to our house is that if you actually are on our hospice. So they'll make people discontinue from that hospice and in order to come to ours. But we're open to anybody because we want to be there for folks.
Tremendous, Scott. That is tremendous. Golly, you think about, of course, for you, and I know you said since you're spread all over the state, you can only spend a limited amount of time here, but you're here a good bit, 3 weeks continuous oftentimes, and even coming down a lot more.
Yeah, I'm probably in the Grand Strand area at least once a month, but we do have a regional president and a regional director that lives here in the area.
Right.
We also have several hospice offices up in the PD. We're
good.
From Bennettsville, Sherrill, Hartsville, Florence, and Lake City, here in the Grand Strand area in Conway and Garden City.
You gave me a phone number earlier, 843-357-0200 for your Garden City location. Even our viewers in the PD could call that to get information about Agape Senior. Of course, agapesenior.com. Ton of tremendous information. If a viewer was visiting that for the first time, what's some of the other great info they're going to get there at your website?
Well, some of the things they'll be able to go through and see all the ancillary, is what we call them, ancillary services that Agape provides. Because what we found is that, you know, as somebody becomes older, their needs, they may come into an assisted living apartment, need nothing more than for us to give them their medicine. But at some point they have an illness, they have a knee replacement surgery or a fractured hip, then we want to make sure that they have transitioned in and are cared for right through the continuum, and we follow them by taking them into a Conway where a rehab center, average length of stay in our rehab center will be 28 days.
Okay.
We do rehabilitation 7 days a week, which is something that most rehab centers and even skilled nursing facilities don't do.
Good
our principle
you.
Is, you, as soon as they get out of the hospital, the quicker they get into rehab, the quicker they're going to be better and quicker they're going to get home. So when you come in on Friday afternoon, you're going to be assessed and you're going to start therapy on Saturday, not waiting until Monday,
Monday.
To get usually what happens is you come in on a Friday, you don't even get assessed until Monday afternoon, which means you don't start rehab till Tuesday. You go 5 days and not
having what's going to happen in those 5 days,
Exactly. So we know the quicker we get it started, 3 hours every single day of intense rehab. We do a lot of creative things in rehab to get people involved. We were the first in the state, I believe, in our rehab unit to put the Wii video games as part of our rehab program. Got a huge 42-inch plasma screen TV in our rehab centers. And what we've got is we started off with the bowling game. We had a guy who came in and he literally could not walk, had not moved at all out of the hospital bed for 6 weeks.
No.
And so what a challenge.
Yeah.
You know, because his muscles wouldn't work. And so, we started playing the Wii game. And he used to be a bowler, and he wanted to get up and play that game so bad.
Right.
And so that was part of his motivation. And so we would lay him out on the mat, or kind of a simulated bed, and he would sit on the edge of it, and he would take that remote control, and he would do like this to bowl. Well, then we finally got him up in the wheelchair and started moving him there. And by the time he left, in about a six-week period, that man was bowling, and he was actually doing his bowling walk and move and everything.
You are kidding, Scott. Where is he?
He's actually in our Columbia.
We'd love to do a story on him. That is tremendous.
One of the newspapers.
A paper in the Midlands would probably nag that or tag that already.
No, but I'll send you a copy of it. You
might
want to
run
it down here.
That could be tremendous. Yes. And just seeing examples of that. Now, are the Wii's located around the state, or just the one?
No, we've got Wii's. Yeah. And actually, what we did is we created a Wii team. We hired teenagers to come in afternoons and on the weekends, and they're the Wii team, and they take this Wii video machine and they carry it around to every area, whether it's our Alzheimer's dementia areas or whether our enhanced care's nursing homes, and they just go around and play.
Get down.
Yeah, and it gets people up, and all of a sudden they're exercising and rehabbing, and they don't even know it. Because they're having such a good time. So we have fabulous Fridays where we do group therapy, and we get everybody together, and every week it's something different. And we will have patients who will beg for us not to discharge them until after Friday so they can go through fabulous Fridays.
Oh, come on,
I promise you. They'll say, I'm not going home until at least 2 o'clock on Friday afternoon because I want to go. And families will come in and watch and play and all. So it's all about an atmosphere of love and excitement and joy, and that's what Agape Rehab is.
And
really
still faith-based, which is wonderful to recognize, coming back to a central purpose there.
We have about 15 chaplains across the state, full-time people who work for Agape Senior, which is very unusual for, quote, the nursing home industry, to have people who work for the facilities themselves.
Right.
They also work together in peer groups to help support each other, help learn new programs that might be helpful for folks, but doing Bible studies, one-on-one chaplain services, it's real important to our residents that they don't lose that opportunity to worship when they come into one of our entities or facilities.
Absolutely. Yeah. Boy, Scott, that is tremendous. You're like a kid in a candy shop talking about it. Just
every
thrilled.
Single
I'm
day.
Sure you've got anecdotal and direct examples from all over the state, all over your locations. Y'all have how many? Of course, you're about to celebrate your 10th anniversary in 2009, a real focus there, which is very exciting. You said you set up the company in 1999.
In 1999, we started with a 40-bed assisted living facility in West Columbia.
Right.
We were about a mile from Lexington Hospital off of I-26.
Yeah.
And over the course of the years, we were able to either purchase or start building different facilities. And now we have nine facilities across the state. We have four that are under construction, though.
Wow.
Across the state.
Including in Conway.
The one in Conway.
Great.
That's right.
Good.
And actually, in Conway, we will be starting a groundbreaking for another new building in Conway in about 30 days. We're
tremendous.
Trying to get through permitting right now.
Wow.
And so we will build a 30-unit assisted living apartment complex that will go with the skilled nursing facility and the enhanced and Alzheimer's care that we already offer there on that
wonderful,
campus.
Wonderful, Scott. Yes. Now, of course, this is a heavily regulated industry. It's not something that a lot of folks can just step into. They can't open up assisted living facilities or skilled nursing and rehab or even hospice. That is something, maybe hospice less so, but the other ones, there's a lot of regulations, a lot of requirements that have to be
met. It's the most heavily regulated industry in the country. And I get so frustrated because a lot of times the nursing home quote industry gets this bad press about, you know, bad things that happen in nursing homes. But the truth is there's more bad things happening to seniors in their home environment than there are in nursing homes, because the home environment is completely unregulated. Mm-hmm. So for example, you decide to keep mama at home and you go out and hire a sitter. Those sitters are not licensed. Even if you go to an agency, they are not licensed. They are not governed at all. They don't necessarily have to have background checks on their folks. They don't follow up. So you never really know when a person comes into your home what they may do or not do to monitor with whereas we are so regulated. I mean, we have state and federal agencies that are coming in and various agencies that are coming in on average probably 3 to 4 different inspections on in a given year.
And they can
year.
Pop in anytime they want, any day of the week.
Anytime, and anybody can call one of the state ombudsman's offices and say, I've got concern, and then they're there. In fact, we're working with the state ombudsman office now to actually, they've got a volunteer program that they're coming out with where they will place a volunteer ombudsman and assign them to a facility.
Right.
And we're working with them because we want to be the first people to do that. So
I
we would
it.
Actually have an ombudsman person who is stationed in our Garden City and Conway facilities on a regular basis to make sure that they watch and oversee, and they're there for any patient concerns at
That's
all.
That's tremendous, Scott. Yeah. Good for y'all being saying, bring it, not bring it on, but
bring
come
it,
on in.
Right, yeah. Because we want to work with them. We work really close with the ombudsman offices here, because what happens is they get into a lot of situations at home where people aren't being cared for and they're looking for placement. So we try to help and work with them.
And I'm sure if there is anything, you want to make sure, you want to be made aware of it. You want to make sure that they let you know about anything.
Yeah.
And both good and anything else. And of course, it's all good.
One of the things is you'll see we have a host of these companies. We have a pharmacy, an ambulance, a physician's practice. And one of the things that sets us apart different is that we have a physician assistant or nurse practitioner who work in our entities and work for Agape Senior. And they work for either one of the local physicians in the area. And they actually come to our facility to see our residents. So we're not always having to pack them up, put them in an ambulance or a transport, take them and let them sit 2 hours at a doctor's office appointment, waiting for the doctor. All of that can be done there. Blood work, any kind of lab work and stuff can be drawn right there in the facility and taken. So we try to help maneuver the system for folks so that when children and relatives are coming to visit, they come to visit. They don't come because I got to coordinate mama's medical schedule and her doctor visits, or I don't have to run to the pharmacy and pick up her prescriptions. I can actually come and just spend time with mom, being her daughter and taking care of her.
I can't fathom all this that you're highlighting. Is this all coming out of you and Evelyn's heads, all out of your head, all out of, or was there a model you saw somewhere else in the country with this brilliant idea of covering all bases there? Is there some other example, or is this entirely novel to Agape Senior nationwide?
Well, we actually created the model here in South Carolina.
Brilliant.
Because we started out with assisted living, and we started looking at where our residents and patients were having most issue.
Mm-hmm.
And so each one of our organizations have really grown out of a patient need.
Right.
And they're not all profitable organizations.
Right,
let me tell you that,
course,
too.
Yeah.
Sometimes that's the mission, that we offer to somebody, because we know that that's a needed service for our patients, and so we reach out to take care of them. But what one of the things I was going to point out, the only thing that we don't do in all of this continuum of care is we don't provide home care services. And a lot of times people will say, well, gosh, Scott, why don't you do that? And my biggest issue is that on a short-term basis, having somebody come in and sit with mom while she's recuperating from an illness is a good thing.
Right.
But honestly, once a person gets to the point where they can't drive, they cannot get out, they start to lose socialization skills because they are in a home by themselves sometimes 20 to 24 hours a day without any communication with anybody else.
Mm-hmm.
And what we found is that it causes a host of other illnesses. They sit in front of the TV and they don't do anything all day long.
Right.
So
hopefully we're catching you right now. But other than that, yes, excuse me.
Exactly. But what we found is that when people of any age come into our environment, even if they're very independent, we've got a lady living with us up in the Columbia area right now who was going to turn 100 in this summer. We do nothing for her. She actually is one of the most active people at Agape Senior. She is an artist and she paints.
Wow.
She is part of our resident council. She is on the internet every single day because we do have wireless internet connections throughout all of our buildings.
Right.
So they can bring their laptops or their computers and hook right on. She emails her family. She leads the exercise programs for her building every single day. And because she has been so active and she has so many friends in the facility, we contribute that to why she has such great health. She's in great shape and great condition and living a full and vibrant life even at 100.
At 100, tremendous.
But she's been living with us for almost 15 years.
Is that right?
Yeah.
That is
so
tremendous.
She came in at the right time. She came in when she had an opportunity to meet people and get to be friends with folks and get involved in the community.
Scott, we've run out of time, but I'm sure viewers have got to be thinking, what is driving Scott? What's this all about? What is it for you? Obviously you're lifting it up to the Lord. You're being guided by Him, but
the vision is, every vision that we've had has come as a gift from God that has showed us where we needed to go for our next step. And I will tell you that every once in a while, especially when I go to national conferences, I come back with all these regulations that we are required to keep up with, and I think, why in the world are we in this business? But here's why we're in there. Got a telephone call from a preacher friend of mine not long ago, and it was a woman, and she says, Scott, I don't know what I'm going to do. I'm getting ready to go in the hospital. My husband is ill. He can't take care of himself, and I'm probably not going to be able to go straight back home when I leave. Tell me what to do. And I said, don't worry about a thing. I said, you go on to the hospital. We got her husband seen to the doctor. We got made sure that he and actually he had some issues and needed to be hospitalized. Both of them came out of the hospital, shared the same room in our rehab center for about 3 weeks. We got both of them intense rehab for about three hours every day for about 3 weeks, and they were able to go home last week. And I look back and I go, that's why I do it.
Right.
Because people call me and they're hurting, they're in pain, and they don't know how to work this system.
Right.
And Agape will take care of it all.
That's great. Scott,
yeah.
Sorry, we've run out of time.
You.
Thanks so much for being with us this morning. Stay tuned for a little more Scott Middleton coming up next. I was working like heck to get it down to 9 words. I couldn't. I got it down to 10 to match up with the 9 points in that beautiful star, the logo for Agape Senior. Think about it. These 10 words, real simple. Integrated health services for seniors in a faith-based atmosphere. If I didn't have that A in there, I could have gotten it. Integrated health services for seniors in a faith-based atmosphere. Take the time to learn more about Agape Senior online. AgapeSenior.com or pick up the phone, 843-357-0200. Scott Middleton, so many others making a difference every day in the lives of seniors. Take the time, AgapeSenior.com. Scott, thanks so much for being with us
this
morning.
Thank you.